back, especially in the Germanic core of Europe. Why?
Well, it's the same thing that followed along the third and second waves. It gets colder, people go inside. Unfortunately, in Austria and parts of Germany, the vaccination rate isn't as high as the authorities wanted it to be. Here in Austria, we're about 64%. Vienna, the capital, is doing fairly well. Our incidence per 100,000 people here in Vienna is about 400. It's in the provinces, especially along the provinces that border parts of Germany, where you have a real serious spike in cases, 1,200 incidents per 100,000 people.
Jonathan, why is there a reluctance among some in Austria to get the vaccine? What is holding that vaccination rate back, and how is it breaking out across the rest of the Eurozone in terms of infection rates?
Yeah, well, I mean, there's a strong but vocal minority of people. They call themselves lateral thinkers, who are protesting frequently on the streets against face masks, against the vaccine. The government yesterday announced that the new rules, which are putting a lockdown on unvaccinated people, preventing them from circulating in places like fitness studios, cinemas, retail shops, you know, this is all intended to drive more people to vaccine stations to get vaccinated. The early indications based on the lines at vaccination centers is that more people, in fact, are going. There's quite a long line at open stations.
Okay, so it is maybe having the impact that the government wants it to, Jonathan. I mean, just tell us a bit more about the Austrian rules here, because they are, I don't know, it's probably not the first time in the world that we're separating people into vaccinated and unvaccinated. There are plenty of other instances of that, but there's not much of it in Europe.
Well, I mean, it definitely carries a political risk. I mean, it's the equivalent almost of like a stop and frisk campaign without the frisking, because the police have made very clear, the Interior Ministry made very clear yesterday, that everybody is subject to being stopped by the police. They're going to be asked whether they have a vaccine passport. If they're caught going into a place where they shouldn't be, an individual will be fined 500 euros, and the business owner or proprietor will be fined 3,600 euros if they're caught with caught allowing people in who shouldn't be there. So, I mean, you know, there's a broad security element to these new rules, and we'll see how that plays out politically and public health-wise in the days and weeks ahead.